Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 320. You got the NASDAQ off 136. S&Ps are off 36. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, it's very easy to get Steve's newsletter. Kick the year off right, folks. Start it off right. Get the newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go right under newsletters. You're going to see Mastering Probability on the right-hand side. You can get the newsletter for 1 month for $149. You get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. And you can get it for a year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 or 33%. Now, they all come, folks, with a 30-day money-back guarantee. You get them. You enjoy it. Great. Something works. If it doesn't work for you, guess what? You just tell us. You're going to get your money back. Check it out right in the front page of TFNN. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Football playoffs.
I know, man. I know. And how about Pittsburgh, huh? I mean,
yeah.
You know, I was happy for Ben big time. I mean, I want to see Tampa win, but if I didn't have a team, I'd almost, that'd be quite an ending to a, you know, career if you, you know, basically.
He's a great player.
Yeah.
You know, he is the type of guy that just never gives up, you know, which is, and many athletes have that same thing.
Sure.
But in the case of, you know, in his case, he's, you know, you love watching him play. I love watching
Seriously.
Him play, that's for sure.
It seems like these guys, just like, remember, I mean, 3 or 4 years ago, we're talking about hockey players just keep getting better. These football players keep getting better, man. It's like, it's amazing, man.
The catches, these receivers.
Exactly, exactly. You know, that's kind of what I'm talking about, too. I know. And, yeah, it's like, how do you do that, man?
I think it's called a lot of sticky on their gloves. But still, even that, you know, even if the gloves are a little sticky, still, it's extraordinary, you know, in real time, in real time, fast action. It is amazing to see some of these plays. So tonight's game, though, that's the big game right now. We've got the Georgia-Alabama game.
Oh, yeah, so, right. Oh, that's going to be good. So, okay, good.
Yeah, so that'll be a big game.
That's something to look forward to big time. Yeah, I like it.
Yeah. I play in a football pool every college football season.
Okay.
This is the first year that I have been – I'm tied in first place with two other guys.
Oh,
if I get I've won the largest number of games. So if I win tonight's game, I win the tiebreaker and the whole bit. But the question is, which of these two teams is going to win? It's going to be a close game, you know. And
so who do you have? I'll be cheering.
I've got Alabama.
I'll cheer for Alabama. Perfect.
Yeah. And in my football pool, I chose Alabama and Georgia to make it to the finals.
Okay.
So, but, you know, and during this football playoff season and with Omicron and all the COVID, you know, so many games were canceled.
Yeah.
So many games you had to go back and take a look at who was playing, who was out sick,
right.
You know, who wasn't. I think so far, I think the staffs are pretty healthy, or the players are pretty healthy. So that, you know, you're going up against, you know, just great teams. I mean, these are both kind of like NFL quality team. So should be a great game. I've got Alabama. I don't think I'll change it. But I won't be surprised to see either team win.
No,
you know, that's the problem. So in any event, if we just get to the markets here real quickly, one of the patterns that I've shared with you and all of our listeners out there that I use to help identify tops and bottoms is the TD9 count. And so this morning at about 11 o'clock, we had TD9 count bottoms that formed inside the ES, the Dow Equity Future Contract, the YM, and the RTY. The NQ, which staged a nice, as you've mentioned, staged a nice rally, that formed a buy the D point. So all four of these equity future contracts had formed valid bottom patterns. So that what was cool was coming and doing the 1 o'clock show. Markets were still down and kind of pulling back, was to be able to share with folks and step by step walk through what the markets were communicating to us. So the TD9 count's really important pattern. I teach that to subscribers. We use it during the radio shows. And you may recall a few weeks ago, before we were coming into the end of the year, I had mentioned that this is starting to look real serious, that we could see a pullback of perhaps 2 to 3 years. And the reason is because when I took a look at the yearly charts for the indices, we had the Dow form a TD9 count top, the S&P, the Russell 2000, the semiconductor index, the NASDAQ composite, and the New York Stock Exchange. So four of these six indices that are on our charts out here show yearly TD9 topping signals, and we may just get a pullback in, you know, into October. That's one possibility. The other possibility is this turns into something more ominous and maybe a 2 to 3 year pullback out here. So the last time, if you take a look at, I think it's the S&P 500 where I've got the blue diagonal arrow, okay, you'll see the last time we had a TD9 count, we saw that 3 year pullback. So that's part of where this comes from.
Yeah.
If I take a look at, Tom, the daily index charts out here, each of them have topping patterns. So the Dow's got a TD9 count pattern. The S&P has a butterfly sell, a sell the D point pattern. The NDX 100 has a Rhodes momentum indicator top. The Russell's got a sell the D point pattern. The semiconductor index has a Rhodes momentum indicator signal. We've got daily charts are suggesting, okay, we've got a top in place. Weekly charts, last week, we've got confirmations inside the Dow for a weekly top, inside the S&P, the NASDAQ, the Russell 2000. So the semiconductors, kind of the whole kit and caboodle. So, and one of the things that, now, what we should at least at a minimum anticipate here, Tom, is we're in the unfavorable seasonal cycle, which typically begins right in the middle of last week. So January 6th, I don't remember if that was Wednesday or Thursday of last week out there, but one of the days last week. And so we should see the markets pull back at least through the end of the month, which is typically right around the end of January from a seasonal standpoint. If we do get some type of bottom towards the end of the month and that bottom eventually gets taken out, that's what's going to be another signal for you and I that the markets are likely to head lower, at least into the October timeframe. Now, where I come with the October timeframe, there's really two time periods during the year on an annual basis when the markets make their significant bottom. The first one is the end of January. The second one is typically sometime around the middle of October.
Okay.
So that's why I say if we form a bottom and then it fails, to me that's a signal that we go down into that next bottoming time frame, which could be October, or it could be more than that. So those are some of the things that I'm looking at. And you had mentioned with your last guest, you know, volatility is rising. And you and I talked about this last week. This is a weekly chart of the volatility index, and this is at the bottom portion of the screen. And going back into the 2007 top, we had a rising bottoms, and that's that yellow diagonal area. Well, guess what? We've got a rising bottoms pattern that's been in place here since 2018. And when you put that together with those yearly TD9 count tops, that's what really has me concerned. But the real proof in the pudding will be if we see closes below the bottom of the weekly profiles. In the upper right-hand corner is the ES Mini.
Yeah.
And those green lines, they represent the support levels. These are the bottoms of the weekly profiles, the TAS market profiles. Now, there's a new one, Tom, that's attempting to form. So I just wanted to update you and our listeners out there because the new level to be watching, assuming this takes hold, I won't really know till Friday, but right now we have to go with the data we've got. It's 45.49.
Okay.
If we see the ES Mini close below 45.49, Tom, that's going to be a signal for you and I that we've got a change in trend in the market. And, you know, you got to take this stuff step by step. We got the daily top. We got the yearly topping signal, says caution. The daily topping signals that are in there, weekly topping signals that are in, a rising spot volatility index. And now we've just got these levels here, the bottom of these weekly profiles, that'll give us the final answer to this puzzle.
And folks, take it seriously, as Steve just said, because the bottom line is that you can study it right now. And it's a lot easier when you study it when it
yes.
comes. Yeah,
yes,
right?
Yes,
I
yes.
mean, thanks, man.
Totally.
Great education,
yeah.
man. We've been doing this long enough. It's a lot easier aware of where are the signs, man. Where are the signs?
That's yeah. right. That's right.
Have a great one, Steve. Have a safe one. Go Alabama.
Thanks.